My name is Amit, and today I am going to demonstrate you live example of how to perform intercompany elimination, how HFM handles intercompany transaction and how elimination take place. So before we proceed and understand do actually how intercompany elimination take place, let's understand the basic concept. The concept is very simple. The simplest way to understand intercompany transaction is you have a money in your left pocket, you put the money from your left pocket, take it and put into left right pocket. This is an example of intercompany transaction. So intercompany transaction happening, it happens within the same company between two subsidiaries. This is an easy example to understand. The customer place an order to the French office. Customer place an order to the French office. French office in turn, French sales office in turn passes the order to German warehouse, and German warehouse ships the order to French sales office. French sales office make the payment and German warehouse render the intercompany invoice. The product shipment is done from warehouse to customer, and finally a customer invoice has been generated by your French sales office. So in this example, customer is an external entity and the transaction is happening between your two subsidiaries, French sales office and German warehouse. The entity which participate into this intercompany transaction called intercompany partners or ICPs. So there are three important keywords you should be knowing: intercompany partners and intercompany invoice and the account which participate during intercompany transaction. Intercompany elimination take place automatically in HFM. The moment you perform consolidation, elimination take place automatically. According to HFM documentation, elimination happen this way. In this example, we consider plant 1 and e-sales. They are two entities where they are intercompany partners where transition is happening. So e-sales has taken some goods or services from plant 1. So e-sales, they record this as the account dimension member is rental expenses. Corresponding to plant 1, it is rental revenue. So what is rental expenses for e-sales? For plant 1, it is rental revenue. So upon consolidation, the rental revenue, rental expenses consolidate to the parent level, which is Connecticut. The common parent between e-sales and plant 1 is USA. And elimination happened to the common parent. Plant 1 also, when you consolidate it, the value reaches to California, and finally the highest level of consolidation happened from California and Connecticut to USA, where rental revenue, rental expenses get adjusted and they turns out to be 0-0. So in HFM, elimination process happen automatically. In this process, there is one more account is used, that is called plug account, which store the offset values. In this case, we assume plant 1 and e-sale, these two subsidiaries agree upon the common numbers. It may possible they are not agree upon the common numbers and there are some discrepancies. This discrepancy to be handled by your plug account. In order to easy to understand, we'll take another example. Assume there's a parent entity which has got two subsidiaries A and B, and correspondingly there are two accounts, sales intercompany and Cox intercompany. Sales intercompany, Cox intercompany, I associate IC is kind of intercompany standard we use. A sales intercompany takes some products from B, which is Cox intercompany. So if they are common, when they adjust on common parent, as long as the value is same, the overall output turns out to be zero at parent level. However, when they do not agree on some values, the difference is stored in a separate account. This is called plug account. Plug account store the plug account store the offset values. So if they do not agree on common thing, let's say this value is 1400, the 100 value will comes to plug account. Also, HFM uses another dimension member. It's part of value dimension called elimination. Elimination member automatically store the negative value of the given negative values of sales and COGS. So at the correspondent sales in the company, the elimination value, elimination member of your value dimension stored minus 1500 over here, and I assume this is 1400, so it turns out a minus 1400. So upon consolidation at parent level, plus 1500 minus 1500 turns out to be 0. Similarly, COGS 1400 minus 1400 turns out to be 0 upon consolidation, and the offset value is 100 assigned to my plug account, and this way elimination take place. Let's see the live example to have even better understanding about it. So I will be using my desktop client. You can see the desktop client and modify my metadata in order to prepare my intercompany transaction example. This is done in two steps. I need to identify the entities participating in intercompany transaction, and they are called intercompany partners. Then we identify the account, identify the accounts participating in intercompany transaction. There are a couple of properties in HFM we set through which HFM understand the given entity is intercompany, is ICP, is the intercompany partner. And in addition to this, there are more properties like security class and all. Right now we are focusing on these properties. Is ICP. So identify the entity and account, right, which are going to participate, and also specify the plug account which it's going to store the value, offset value, when your two entities do not agreed upon. Let's see. So I open the existing metadata of my practice application. This is my practice application in my C drive, HFM working folder, practice application. Under metadata, I open my practice application. It's XML extension. First, I select entities which are going to participate in intercompany transaction. So I see in my California, I have two entities, Sunnyvale and Foster City. The property I need to set them is ICP, right? Is ICP, the two property to set. Okay. And in addition to this, we also need to specify security as partner class. So right now, I'm just leaving it. We'll talk about this in greater detail in a security session. We specify is ICP property set to true. The moment you make any entity is ICP true, automatically the given entity added in your ICP dimension. I show you in this example. So in this case, Sunnyvale and Foster City is ICP true. When I look at my ICP dimension, I will be finding these two entities are automatically there. I should mention I used over here. Let me create a new. I just want to show you the metadata. I can open my any document and show you the metadata where I could see the ICP dimension. So I just want to take a snapshot of this. So you see Sunnyvale and Foster City. Foster City and Sunnyvale automatically available. ICP is a system defined dimension, and the moment when entity dimension member set to is ICP equals to yes, the given member automatically gets added into ICP dimension. ICP is a system defined dimension. Right? So you see Sunnyvale and Foster City automatically added in your ICP dimension. That is first property. So I'll set, in this case I do not need to specify both of them are is ICP, so yes. Next, I go to my account dimension and check which account member is going to participate in an intercompany transaction. I don't have any account. What I do, I'll just change this. I'll make one more account, sales. I make is ICP equals to yes, right? And I add another member, COGS, cost of goods sold. Okay, I just add a prefix call, postfix call IC to demonstrate the intercompany. And I say is ICP equals to yes. And also specify parent is a gross margin. Right? And sales also just rename it for the sake of testing. Rename sales IC intercompany. So now I have got two account, sales intercompany and cost intercompany. Ideally you should create two instances of each account, intercompany and third party. Now I create another account called plug account. Plug account is the account which is stored the any value where two entities do not agree upon. So plug account, plug AC. So this account, it is going to be used by sales intercompany and cost intercompany. I also quickly cross check my COGS should be expense type. COGS is expense type. And in case you need to also specify plug account. The plug account in sales intercompany is plug PL, plug AC. For sales IO also, plug account is plug account, right? So third point which you should write over here is specify the plug account. Identify the account participate in intercompany transaction and specify plug account. Right, so metadata ready in order to demonstrate intercompany transaction. Now I save this metadata and I load this. So I log into my workspace. I already logged in. I would like to log off and log in again. I log into my workspace, open my HFM application and load this metadata. HFM application, and I go to load section. There's an option called application elements. I just want to load metadata. I like to clear existing metadata, point to this and load my metadata. Then I'm going to click on load. Metadata gets loaded. It takes few seconds to load the metadata. Metadata gets loaded. Now we'll perform intercompany transaction and see how it works. So I'm going to create a new data form where we'll see intercompany transaction how it takes place. HFM does this job automatically. So when I consolidate in HFM automatically take place. Consolidation function invoke calculation. It consolidation automatically invokes currency conversion. Consolidation automatically invokes intercompany elimination. Right? To see the difference, let's create a data form or data grid. I'll create new document. And I create new document. New data grid. In a data grid, in my row section I place account and ICP. So what account dimension I need? I need sales intercompany and COGS intercompany. So I select sales and plug account. And in addition to this, I also like to see my intercompany transaction. So I drag and drop place over here, ICP. ICP dimension I'll be selecting. Fossil City, Sunnyvale, and ICP top member. So I could see the post consolidated value. Then in my column dimension, I'll be selecting entity and value. So I drag and drop entity. Remove my value from here. Just move it from here to point of view. Entity and value dimension. As I said, value dimension, the member call elimination automatically store the negative value of the user input. So upon consolidation, value turns out to be zero. Entity, Sunnyvale, Foster City, and common parent is California. And value dimension I select elimination, entity currency and elimination. Entity currency and elimination, right? I'm going to save this as intercompany elimination, intercompany elimination version 1. Intercompany elimination already exists, so I make version 1, right? That's it. Now we'll test it. So open your intercompany elimination and we enter some data and see how it happened. So California is the parent, Sunnyvale and Foster City are the children. My entity currency, I can select USD or entity currency, any one of them. And my accounts are sales intercompany, Cox intercompany for Foster City and Sunnyvale. So sales, I input 1500 and you see the cell turns out to be yellow color, say dirty cell. And Cox for Sunnyvale, I input 1400. They do not agree upon the common value, right? I go to action and submit this data. Now I'll perform consolidation. I can perform consolidate parent level, right click consolidate all, or I could consolidate for a specific intersection. Consolidation going on. It takes few more seconds. Consolidation is done. Let's go to our data grid, refresh it, and this is what happening. Right, point one, elimination automatically store the same value with negative symbol, 1500 plus minus 1500. At parent level, it is going to consolidate parent level. California, it turns out to be zero. Similarly, 1400 and minus 1400, at parent level, it consolidated and turned out to be zero. The difference between both of them is automatically stored in your plug account, which is 100. Because sales was revenue and COX was expense type, therefore it's a plus 100. 1500 minus 1400 equals to plus 100. So you see, this is how HFM automatically take care of intercompany elimination. That's it for today. In a subsequent session, I'm going to talk about how to automate cash flow in HFM and intercompany elimination. We already discussed today, we'll see cash flow and equity pickup. Keep subscribed to our channel, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and keep watching our videos. Thanks for watching today's session. Should you have any question related to training and consulting, please visit our site www.bispTrainings.com.